We begin tonight at 10 with a proposed state question that could mean expanded Medicaid in our state.
When the Affordable Care Act was passed under President Obama, states were allowed to expand the number of residents covered by Medicaid. Most states said yes. Oklahoma did not. Some Oklahomans made too much to qualify for Medicaid, but not enough to qualify for insurance under the Affordable Care Act.
More than 110,000 Oklahomans fell into this coverage gap with no insurance at all. Today, supporters of the expansion holding yes on 802 events all over the state.
For some at Saturday's event, the push to expand Medicaid is personal. Aaron Taylor's son has had significant medical issues since birth.
He had a heart transplant when he was 4 years old, and he also has an intellectual disability. And if we didn't have Medicaid as our secondary insurance to provide his care, it would bankrupt my family. I want to see other families have the benefits my family does.
Organizers and volunteers out in force continuing the process of getting the signatures necessary to put Medicaid expansion to a statewide vote. Supporters of expanding federal medical coverage holding events in Miami, Enid, Ardmore, McAllister, Duncan, Tulsa, and Oklahoma City on Saturday.
It's an important way to ensure that Oklahomans are healthy and productive.
They need to get 178,000 Oklahomans to sign on the line by October 28th.
This brings federal dollars back into Oklahoma that Oklahoma taxpayers have paid to the federal government.
But not all agree. The governor most recently spoke out against Medicaid expansion at the State of the State. He also mentioned the hidden cost while running for governor last November.
I'm also going to be thinking about taxpayers, and nobody really talks about the cost and burdening taxpayers for $200 million but up to $1 billion in the future. And as governor, I'm going to tell them exactly what the unintended consequences are of expanding Medicaid.
Some House and Senate leaders have spoken out against the expansion. They say the current plan for Medicaid would actually cost the state money. They say there are better ways to get federal health care dollars.
The straight up Medicaid expansion is a cookie cutter approach, and I think that we need something more tailored to our citizens. There's plans out there. This thing is totally doable, and so we're ready to get to work and figure out if we can put a dent in our health rankings.
Well, if yes on 802 can get the necessary signatures within 90 days, the question likely to appear on a statewide ballot in November of 2020.